Here we want to add the fractions and make sure that our sum is in simplest form. The most important thing to remember about adding fractions is we have to obtain a common denominator. So looking at our first example, we have 3/5 plus 1/6. So looking at the denominator of 5 and the denominator of 6, the least common denominator is going to be the least common multiple of 5 and 6, which in this case would be 30. So we need to rewrite each of these fractions with a denominator of 30. So I'll have to multiply the numerator and denominator of 3/5 by 6, and multiply the numerator and denominator of 1/6 by 5. Notice how in both cases we're multiplying by a fraction that has a value of 1, therefore we're just changing the form of the fraction, but they will be equivalent fractions. So when we multiply these two fractions, we're going to have 18/30. We multiply here, we're going to have 5/30. Now that our denominator is the same, we can add the fractions. The denominator is going to stay the same, and then we add the numerator. So 18 plus 5 is equal to 23. In our second example, we have 12/27 plus 2/9. So the first step is to determine our least common denominator, which is going to be the least common multiple of 9 and 27. So this question is a little bit more challenging. So what we can do is use the prime factorization of the denominators to help us determine the least common denominator. So what we're going to do is rewrite this first fraction as 12 over the prime factorization of 27, which would be 3 times 3 times 3, plus 2 over the prime factorization of 9, which is 3 times 3. So now, keeping in mind that in order to add these fractions, the denominators must be the same, notice how if this fraction here had an extra factor of 3, the denominators would be the same. So we can multiply by a factor of 3 here as long as we do the same to the numerator. So by using the prime factorization of the denominators, we can identify the LCD by determining which factors we must multiply by to make the denominators the same. Now let's go ahead and rewrite these with our common denominator. This is going to be 12/27, the original fraction, plus this fraction here is now going to be 6/27. Denominator stays the same. Add the numerator. 12 plus 6 is equal to 18. But we can't forget to simplify here. We saw above the prime factorization of 27 would be 3 times 3 times 3. And the prime factorization of 18 would be 2 times 3 times 3. So this simplifies. 3 over 3 simplifies to 1 here and here. So the final sum here is 2/3. We'll take a look at one more example in the next video.